monster.
My eyes couldn't follow it. This was the devil's path, and the staircase was great.
I can't stop this.
I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception who got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play. And always in character.
Had been there. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Okay, let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady
Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery. And all leading up to him, meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He'd only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
Not you again. The dark presence had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker. The muse was the murder victim. The final scene took place in room 108.
Asking too many freaking questions. Not letting us proper police take care of it.
This is our chance to make the powers that be happy. We'll be set for life. Part of the inner circle.
Well, amen to that, partner. I like it. And so will the fraternity, the club, the word. Our dear friends with many names. The way I see it, it was a lone nut job. A junkie out of his mind on some fancy new designer drug.
Open and shut case. All we gotta do now is dump the evidence from room 108 in the usual place in the alley.
Ah!
seen it changed. This was the murder site. There was a record at the bottom of the bathtub, beneath the body. Another step. Somehow I was closer to home, closer than ever before. It's you again. The FBI agent. Saga Anderson. I'm closer now. I can feel it. You helped me get closer to escaping.
Wake. Are I still trapped? The clicker. We can figure
it out. You know about the clicker. It can help us. I destroyed the dark presence with it last time. You can help. You can find it. You must find it.
I can get it to you. I have to understand. Did you write the story?
Alice is in danger. I have to stop Scratch. I have to find Return. I need to get back to my apartment. I'm writing a story to get through. Initiation. It's the only way.
It's a story.
You can do that.
You can write out. She's
it lasted only for a moment, like two planets passing in orbit. Saga Anderson was helping me go deeper. Closer to escape. Somehow, I had to trust her. Parliament Tower. I had to get back to my apartment, my study. I had to find the manuscript of Return.
Some say that it moves forever, this road that I lose you on every time. Some say that it moves forever, this road.
Judgment Tower was here, again. Zane said the manuscript of Return was the key to escaping. I had to get it before Scratch did.
Or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play. Shadows on the wall of a cave, an echo of the true events that happened somewhere else. Was I there to watch the shadows, or was I a shadow too? In a performance set up for someone else.
Alice had turned the bathroom into a dark room. I needed to get inside the manuscript. Alice's work had consumed the apartment.
I didn't leave the apartment.
Her whole life.
I was flattened by the confusion, the shock, the guilt, fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. And he still checks in, even after he moved out west. One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just
ended her whole world. It was the perfect image of the horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera. There was something in the dark. Something I needed to see, to show. The more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for. In the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end.
Some say that it moves forever, this road that I lose you on every time. Some say that it moves forever, this road.
Scratch stopped me before I could finish my edits to the manuscript.
The
The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice. Zane had said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation.
Quiet now. Feels like I've suddenly gone deaf. Those old folks sure can get loud, huh?
I don't mind it. What happened to, grab life's gifts while you...
my name comes up, your books come up. You come up. I've read them. There are echoes of my life in there that makes me feel like someone's been watching me. What happened to Alan Wake? The unanswered mystery. Never expected to find you alive.
Oh, my head's killing me.
I think you like using people, Wake. Taking their lives and twisting them into your stories. And when someone gets hurt, it's kick-ass material for the next one. Shit! Spilled my coffee.
Take it you're not a fan then, Agent Casey.
This is not your playground, and I'm not your fucking creation.
It doesn't work that way. You can't make something out of nothing, even in the dark place where the rules hardly apply. It's very complicated to make fiction come true. I saw visions of what's happening. What will happen? Dreams. I tried to use them in my writing. I understand how dangerous it is now. Even with a paralyzing amount of planning. I think I stopped writing. I think I gave up. But there's a manuscript. Maybe I forgot not to write. The dark place makes you forget. I just want to fix this. Find a version of the story that fixes everything.
Shut up! Get down!
We want the rider!
No one else needs to get hurt!
Fuck! Shit!
Hey! What are you doing?
I had escaped the dark place, so had the dark presence. Scratch. He was here, in Bright Falls. I could feel him as a growing pressure in my head, stronger by the minute. Why didn't he kill me with the rest? What did he want? I needed to find Casey. We were on the same side in this fight. Strength in numbers.